Hello, here's Alex with another Lightroom Develop video. Today I'm looking at a 10-year-old photo that I made in Taiwan in March 2013. My wife and I were taking this hike in the bamboo forest section of a natural area, and it got foggy, which is quite lovely. Fog makes everything better, doesn't it? And I quite like the appearance of the bamboo in the fog, obviously. Duh. And who would have thought I made a couple pictures of it? This is one of those photos that got buried on my hard disk and I've never done anything with it. So I thought, when I take a look at this today, I might as well make a video and show how I would approach it. The first thing you will notice here by looking at the histogram is, of course, damn, this is underexposed. Yes, a lot. So I didn't pay attention to my camera settings. It was in a somewhat gloomy and dark section of that forest, and that misled me into not paying close attention to my histograms and the exposure in camera. I should have dialed in an exposure compensation of at least plus one in order to get that exposure brighter. But I did not do that, so we need to fix it here on the computer. And just looking at the histogram, I know I can easily add two stops of exposure to that image. And now it actually looks much better here with regards to its brightness levels. Ta-da! The next thing that we see is there's a very strong green-yellow tint over the image, which is also expressed in the histogram here. And that's perhaps a result of the very green bamboo reflecting all that light into the fog. Maybe that would actually be accurate. I had my camera set to a daylight white balance here in this situation, but that's not really working too well. So I want to white balance this on the fog to get a better separation of the colors here. And I choose this gray area here where there doesn't appear to be any bamboo. So it's just fog most likely, or perhaps here. And that leads to a better color rendition. The fog is now a neutral gray, which is more like what we would expect in this situation. Next up, obviously that all looks a little bit tilted. And the first thing to do in a situation when there's a lot of straight lines in a photo is not to try and straighten it, but instead go into the lens corrections and enable these. Lightroom detects the lens here from the EXIF data, and Adobe has provided a profile for this lens that I was using, my trusty 24-120 f4 zoom. And then that distortion is gone, which makes it easier to see where does this thing actually tilt to and what do I need to do. Quite an amount of distortion this lens has here at 85mm, but that's not unexpected for a zoom of this focal length range. So now I can go and use my crop tool to try and straighten this. I want to set my aspect ratio precise here, my usual pet peeve. And I could go and try to straighten this now, but what I like to do in these situations, because I'm not really sure which bamboo stalk is actually straight and which isn't, I'm going to turn off the lights by pressing the L key twice in Lightroom. That makes the entire UI darker and then black. And now I can straighten this less by looking at the surrounding areas, being completely undistracted by what's going on, and just looking at what point does this frame feel most straight to me. And I think this is actually good. I'm being drawn to this particular bamboo stalk here. That one is still leaning a little bit. That one leans also in another direction, but maybe that might be natural. Or I tilt it just a tiny bit more to straighten all that out. And then I look at this one here and I think, maybe not. And I find a point where I like it. And then I move my frame around a little bit, looking at the corners to perhaps see if there's any little distractions that I want to get rid of. But then that's my straightening, very nice. So I can bring the lights back on by pressing the L key, and then I close my crop tool. Now when I look at this, and I might turn the lights off again for this, you see that there's less definition here because this area is deeper in the fog, and more definition here because this area is closer to the camera. So that's a bit of an imbalance that I'd somehow like to try and fix. Sometimes it helps to visualize that by flipping the photo around, and then you see now you have an area here that's lighter, and here it gets gradually darker and more defined. Of course, darker in relative terms, but you can see what I mean. I flip it back and I want to fix these two areas and balance them out a little bit so I have a more even appearance of that entire bamboo and the patterns. So what I do here is I go into my masking tools and I create a mask with a linear gradient to make a local adjustment. Obviously, I don't want to use exposure, but I want to solidify this area here a little bit and cut through the fog. And I do that with the dehaze option, of course. Maybe I begin with 40, 30, something in that range. And then I drag this graduated filter here into this side. And I see, yeah, I can probably need a little bit more. And I want to match this closer to the middle here. And that looks good. Quick before and after. I brought that in here. And then I want to do the opposite on the other side. So I create another mask with a linear gradient. And now I use negative dehaze to make this side softer. And I drag this in here. And once more, I try to balance that out. Maybe this is a little bit much. Can bring it back a little bit, perhaps here. That looks good to me. And that way I have evened out these two sides, and it's much more about the lines and the patterns of that bamboo now. And it's not so distracting that this brightness is a little bit uneven across the frame. We can do a quick before and after of these two masks. Before and after, and you see how that just nicely comes together now. Sometimes these brightness differences are not that easy to spot, and in that situation what helps is to actually use the zoom tool here and to zoom out a lot to have a really, really small frame, maybe even smaller than this, almost like a thumbnail. And in this view, I will be able to see much more clearly where the brightness differences lie. And you can see there's a kind of diagonal here in that fog. This corner here is a little bit darker. This corner here is a little bit darker. That center area here is a little bit darker. So maybe I want to adjust that a little bit. I use a new mask, I use a brush, I'm a fan of the brush, and I use the dodge tool for lightening now. I have adjusted this preset to be +1 because I always like to brush with a lower flow so I can gradually go over an area multiple times. Now my brush is obviously way too big, I use my mouse wheel to directly adjust it, and I brush over this, and maybe this central area here, and that corner here. Maybe this bottom here, that, and just even out these different brightness levels. And you see, I just click here and there, very easy single taps to just level that out and make it more even. And once that's done, I can close this tool and I can go back to my regular fit zoom. And I have a very nicely evened out frame here where really the bamboo with its abstract quality is coming out best. And I think the color separation could be better, and I can achieve that by adding some vibrance, of course. And when everything's so flat and muted like it is in a foggy scene, I do not hesitate to actually drag that slider quite a bit into the range of 50, 60 to get nice color rendition here. Makes it look much more lively. Last not least, I can look at my histogram here. Maybe I want to add a little bit of punch with contrast. You see that my starting point is actually a slightly negative contrast. I made that choice deliberately so I can work on the tones with a flatter starting point. And that pretty much concludes the relatively simple edit here in this frame, working with a foggy picture. You see that except for exposure, contrast, and vibrance, I haven't touched any of these local sliders because all that I did is use a couple of masks here to even out the frame, which worked quite nicely, I think. And that's it for today. Stop. We want to do a final before and after with the backslash key. That's the one above the return or enter key on the keyboard. Before, underexposed, distortion, color cast in green. After, evened out exposure, beautiful soft picture, gentle colors, straightened out, and with a much nicer distribution of brightness levels. Now we're done. Thanks for watching. Bye.